So this unit here had its breaker trip, main power downstairs. Shut this disconnect off, reset the breaker downstairs, come back up. Okay, I haven't turned this on yet. I've went through and checked all the loads with my meter. Okay, compressor looks good. Checked everything, the ground here, and everything looks like it's good. This compressor here has been isolated already. It was isolated because it has a, I believe it had a short in it a while back. So it's been isolated, doesn't operate anymore. We didn't receive the go ahead to replace it. So it's just sitting there like this. So we're gonna turn the power on. But first thing you wanna do, you don't want anything to start up in its natural sequence by itself. I pulled the R wire off. So that way the thermostat's not getting any power. So we're not gonna get a signal on any of these back up. So this will just sit stagnant. So if we turn the power on, we should be able to check to see if we have main power without blowing anything, because we're not going to start anything up and then go forward from there. The other thing this does is if we have, let's say we have some carbon tracking on the contactors up there, to ground or across phases, we pull this off and we turn the power on. If we lose power or the breaker trips with this off and the power on, we potentially have a problem on the line side. And when we have a problem on the line side, especially with these Carrier units, we can have carbon across legs of the contactor or back to ground and it will pop instantly. So power is on, okay? Didn't hear any weird sounds, any pops or crackles or anything like that. Checked for main power. We have main power. We have 600 volts, okay, it's there. One thing that I like to do, okay, and you gotta be careful when you do this, is before I go ahead and start everything up after I check it, one thing I like to do is just bump each contactor, okay, with an insulated screwdriver just quickly. Because if you bump it and you hear an odd sound coming from the motor, the compressor, you can track that down real quick and go to it and check it to see if there's anything wrong with it. It's just something that I do, and I'm very cautious when I do it, and I stand back, obviously, and I do it with my hand, my body away from it, and it's just a quick bump. So I've already done this, and what I found is when I bump the blower contactor, which is right there, the blower hums, okay? This compressor starts, sounds good. This blower just kind of hums. So I didn't get anything to ground when I checked it right here on the contactor, but I'm gonna go over to the blower motor itself and check it out, the wiring across all three phases. Okay, I'm gonna check the resistance across all three phases and see what it says. Okay, so I have the wires pulled, okay, and I've taken a picture of where they go just so I know for reference, but this orange, this brown, and this blue are for the motor. And the black, the blue, and the yellow come in, and those are your power wires. So I'm gonna check across these, and I have a funny feeling that we're gonna get some odd readings. Now on a three-phase motor, we should be pretty much the same across all three phases, or all three legs, right? So I'm gonna check it out, and we'll see what happens. Okay, well, I checked across all of them, and I was wrong. It's actually 4.1 across all of them, nothing to ground. Absolutely nothing. So there's a possibility when I bumped that contactor in, it didn't get pushed in all the way and both legs weren't powered up. That will cause that to happen, because basically this fan motor here has one leg powered all the time. That contactor provides the other two legs of power. And if I only have one leg pushed in, we're actually single phasing that motor, and that's what can cause it to hum sometimes. So we're gonna try this again. All right, so even though the ohm readings were good, 4.1 across all three legs, I mean, that seems okay to me. When I push the contactor in, it's still just humming, and it's just kind of moving back and forth like this, just kind of doing that, humming. I checked this contactor because I put my meter to the ohm setting, pushed it in, and checked across each leg. It's closing, okay? There's a big piece of insulation that I noticed inside the blower. I noticed this earlier, but I didn't think anything of it. I thought I just have to fix it, and I saw this inside. I'm like, I wonder if this blower was running imbalance for so long that it's done something to that motor. So what I've done for now is I've closed this, or opened this, sorry, by turning it off. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hook the R wire back up, and I'm gonna check everything else out quickly, like the condenser fan motors, the compressor, all that kind of stuff. And I know the blower's not running, but I can just still run the compressor for a minute or so just to make sure that it runs properly. It's okay, the motor's fine inside. I think the problem's coming from this blower. And what I'm gonna do is once I make a call for fan, only fan, I can come over here and check for power. Make sure I'm getting proper power here. So that's what I'm gonna do next. All right, so now I'm in with these transformers. Taking the cover off this one, and this one here goes on this top one, and when I smell it, it smells like burnt winding. So something has burnt up inside of this one, and it may have gotten wet because my fingers are wet in here. So something happened with this one. I think we're gonna have to get the transformer changed to get our 460 volts back. Like I said, I think that motor's fine. What's going on here is we're missing a leg of power out to that fan motor, right? Because the transformer doesn't have the 460 on it. So we gotta get this transformer replaced, get our 460 back properly, and then we can go from there. So this call keeps getting better. Power's back on, R is jumped to G. Contactor's not pulling in, and I do not have 24 volts at the control transformer. Show you what I got here. I have 7 volts. On the 460 volt side of this transformer, we have 137 volts. We're not getting proper power here. Okay, so this is getting better and better here. So I'm tracing these wires that go to this transformer. I see this big black mark up here. I see this right here. All right, I see this, and this spade connector was inside there, and it's black. And I also see this wire right here. So something has happened here. We gotta figure this out. So it looks like if I can put these puzzle pieces together, that this blue wire goes with this blue wire here, and this black wire goes with this black wire here. I'm gonna put those back together. It just concerns me, that smell over there. I'm hoping we didn't burn that transformer out. But it looks like if I hook these back up, we might have some luck. If not, we're gonna have to replace that transformer over there. It's gonna be our only option. Okay, so I have these wires put back together. And if we look at this, I mean, really, we should have some sort of protection around all of these wires coming through these holes, because they're rubbing against this sharp metal surface, and eventually they're gonna wear through. But for now, I'm gonna leave them like this just for testing. I'm gonna pull that red wire off again, the R wire, and we're gonna see if our blower contactor pulls in. We're gonna see if we have 24 volts here. We're gonna see if we have 460 here. So power's back on, the R wire's pulled off. Okay, we have the LED light on the main control board, which was not on before. Here's where it gets interesting. So we go back to the transformer. We now have power here, okay? But instead of being too low, now it's too high, 32 volts. Okay, we check the top end of that where our 460 is supposed to be coming in. Once I get a good connection there, we have, hard to see there because of the sun, but we have 569. That's supposed to be 460. That tells me that that transformer back there has suffered some damage, and it's providing the wrong power to this control transformer. It's gonna burn it out. Next odd thing, breaker is off to this, okay? I have the R wire put back on, and the contactor has pulled in for the blower. Now I checked power here, and I'm not gonna do this on camera because it's not very safe, but I'm getting 460 volts across one phase and 560 and 560 across the other two phases. That's gonna burn out that motor. That's gonna burn out that transformer.
That transformer back there definitely needs to be replaced because it has suffered some damage from these wires getting disconnected or shorting out on this panel. So that's got to get replaced. And then we'll move on from there.